is of the devil. Sin is of the devil. For the devil sinned from the beginning, from inception. Now the other part is this. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that we might destroy the works of the devil. Now, before the works of the devil are being destroyed, there is need for the first work of grace. Before the works of the devil can be destroyed, we need to come to a place of realization to understand that we cannot save ourselves. And that's why he said, by strength shall no man prevail. And so we should understand that it is not by power, it is not by might, it is not by dedication, neither is it by desire. So once we understand that format, then we will understand that experience grace. To live above sin is to experience grace. So therefore, I will want us to evaluate our life and I will want us to pray and say, Lord, search me. If there are places I have fallen short of your grace, help me. You know, sometimes it is not, those common sins. You carry gun, you shoot somebody, you kill somebody, you steal in mommy's purse, and kind of things like that. There are some sins that are caused by omission. There are some that we do not even, you look at it and you say, no, this is just a small one. I hope you know that unforgiveness is a sin. And this has not fully experienced the first work of grace. When there are unbelief, when you are faithless, you know, when you are faithless, Bible says without faith, it is impossible to please God. You cannot come in alignment with him when you are not pleasing him. And so we need to understand that unbelief, doubt, frustration. Look at the unbelief of the children of Israel, complaining, grumbling, any little thing they never appreciate. God was very angry. And he made the journey of 40 days to become journey of 40 years. You know, sometimes what we go through, if we understand that God is involved, there are greater tendencies that we will not go through as much as that. But any little thing we complain, any little thing we grumble, we murmur, God is definitely not happy. And so the first thing to do is to first of all mortify this aforementioned. Those things that attract God's anger, God's wrath, those things that God counts as sacrilege. We need to mortify them and take them out of our life. And once those ones are taken away, now, this will now bring us to the part B of the prayer for tonight. Therefore, I want you to tell God and say, Lord, evaluate me. Whatever is it that is not of God, take it away from me so that my prayers will not be hindered. Shall we open our mouth and pray? You might be dedicated. You might even have prayer programs. You might even be fasting and praying, but you have this one that this man has done, I will never forgive him. He's a nagging person. And because of that, I hate him. I do not like him. I cannot forgive him. Each time I see him, I'm not even happy with him. I hear about his case, I am very frustrated and I'm very angry. I am always at peace. Once I hear something about it, once I hear anything close to it, I'm not happy. I am disturbed. So I cannot forgive him. Or you are praying and you do not even have faith in what you are praying. You know, that's why God did not answer our prayer most times. When you say you pray, but you do not have faith. Imagine some people, they have spent hours in prayer. And after the prayer, they say, well, if God wills.
And
then they will tell you, well, I hope God will answer. I just hope that God will answer. After you have spent time in praying, now you are just hoping. And that is why they say, without faith, it is impossible to please God. So once you have prayed, and you have faith, and you have belief, and you have trust in Him, then you can partner with Him. You can walk with Him. You can now form alignment with Him. Therefore, I want you to tell the Lord, take away impurity. Anything you hate that I do, consciously or unconsciously, pardon, forgive.
In the name of Jesus.
And give me grace to live above them.
Father, I stand against me and
there are some challenges that are so persistent, that are so weak in our faith, because we thought we are praised. And yet, solution has not come, which brought about frustration, rejection. In fact, some people have even lost their consecration. Because they believe that God is far away from them. How is your prayer life? Are you experiencing prayer lostness? Are you experiencing a fluctuating prayer life?
In the name of Jesus, Holy Father, I pray. Father, I pray.
This is tantamount to faithlessness. Because if you believe God will answer, then why are you frustrated? Why are you discouraged?
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that every prayer that will be prayed here today, you will answer. You will pardon, you will forgive, you will overdo. And Lord, with authority, you will grant all our desires. In the name of Jesus, you will destroy every work of darkness and let your name be glorified. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank
in
you.
Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
If you can hear me, then say louder, amen.
Amen.
In the part B of this verse I read to you, in 1 John chapter 3, verse 8, He said, for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested. For this purpose, we now have Jesus, the Son of God. For this purpose, we have a warrior. We have somebody that is capable. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. The question is, what are the works of the devil? He has told us one. Above, in this verse. He that committed sin is of the devil. So what is, has he come to destroy? He has come to destroy sin. I will ask you, is failure the work of God in your life? No, it is the work of the devil. Is delay work of God in your life? No, it is the work of the devil. Is disappointment the work of God in your life? No, it is the work of the devil. Is hatred the work of grace, the work of God in your life? No, it is the devil. Why is it that people hated me? They hate me, then I will hate them back. Is that the work of God? No. It is the work of the devil. Why is it that everything I do is always wrong? Is it the work of God? No. It is the work of the devil. Why am I experiencing go slow in my academics? Why am I experiencing go slow in my marriage? Why am I experiencing go slow in my business? You want to tell me, is that the work of God? No. It is the work of the devil. Now, for this purpose, for this reason, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. And so tonight, we have come here to destroy every work of the devil in our life. I therefore want you to pray fervently. I want you to pray effectively. I want you to pray now with faith. I want you to pray with all your zeal. I want you to pray, putting everything you have in action. And you are going to tell the Lord, every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit, go ahead and destroy them. Shall we open our mouth and pray? Begin to destroy the works of the flesh. Begin to destroy the work of the devil. The work of witches. The work of darkness. Lord, begin to destroy them. For this purpose.
Every work of the devil.
The Son of God was manifested. He was raised. He was bring on board. So destroy the works of the devil.
Every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit, attack. Every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit, that's on life. Every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit. Every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit, shatter it. Every work of the devil in my life, Holy Spirit, break it to pieces.
Destroy the work of the devil.
In my life, I pray. No matter how over dear it is to me, break it to pieces. Every work of the devil
in my life. We pray.
Amen.
I want you to tell the Lord, when you are beginning to experience lukewarmness in your prayer life, I want you to understand that it is the work of the devil.
Yes.
When you are in financial mess, understand that it is the work of the devil. You are going to pray. Every power of darkness working against my finance, I command in the name of Jesus that their power be destroyed over my life. Their power be destroyed over my business.
My Father, my God, my Creator, my Maker, open my mouth to call upon you because you are a prayer answered.
You will destroy the work of darkness.
My Father and my God.
You collect salary, yet you are still living on borrowed. I'm telling you, it is the work of the devil. Begin a work. You have started a project. And you have left that project now for over 3, 4, 5 years. It is the work of the devil.
Working against my business, working against my religious life. In the name of Jesus, every power regarding me, every power
that
is in the truth of your Lord, destroy them out of my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, every work of the devil, from any for any trouble in this world,
every plant of the enemy to throw me in financial mess.
In the name of Jesus,
my father, working against my head today, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bring all such powers to destruction. Father, release your fire from our heart.
Jesus' name we pray.
In the mighty name of God. Amen.
We are going to pray this prayer again. But I want you to look at it in another dimension. If the devil wants to torment our spiritual life, they have a better means, a way of stiffening people so that they can weaken their prayer life. Let me tell you. You know, those if you get a job, you even get a job, you can easily buy a car, you can easily build a house. I tell you now that even if you get a job, you get one job, you add it to another one, you add it to another one, package everything together. Maybe, perhaps, it will be sufficient for you to eat. Not even for you to build. Or talking of sending children to school. After you have worked one, after you have worked two, you send children to school, yes, you cannot even balance the school fees. Daddy, they say we should bring this. When you see their call, hey, this one wants to ask for money again. And so the devil now occupy us. He preoccupy us with work. So that by the time you come back home at the end of the day, you are tired. The time for prayer, you say, let me rest more. When the alarm rings, you toss the alarm. You off the alarm. Say, let me rest more. It is the living that can praise God. I need to take care of my spiritual health. And so the devil mess you financially. So when you now look at your prayer life, you can pray 4 hours before. But in a day now, you barely struggle with 1 hour. This is the spiritual lukewarmness. And I tell you, it is the work of the devil. You are going to pray one more time. Holy Spirit, bring me out of financial mess. Take me out of this situation where I found myself.
Oh, my Father and my God, I know you know everything about me.
They want to
you
are
the present me. Father, I'm praying and asking, take me out of my financial bereavement. Take me out of my help to reach
where the devil
in thy name of
God. Help me from
my stagnancy. Every time I reject the power of Satan in the name of Jesus. Every work of the devil,
let it be manifested in your life,
concerning my head, concerning my business, concerning my family.
Let it be manifested financially so that the work of the devil might be destroyed.
My Father and my
the work of the devil might be destroyed.
Financially, the power of growth, spiritually, the power of growth. In wellness, oh my Father, release upon my life and my family today in the name of Jesus, and destroy every plan of the wicked one, Satan, the devil, to bring me down.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
You know, when we talk of frustration can come. In fact, frustration is very wide. One can experience frustration financially. You can also experience frustration ministerially. When you bring up a program, let us have a powerful 3 days. And at that 3 days, you do not even seek cooperation from anybody. The more you try, the more the thing is not even working. Then you will not, you know, some people will tell you that I have prayed. I'm not even seeing anything. As a result of that, they are discouraged. Frustration can come in different angles. It can come at the place of your work. It can even come from your own house. Frustration is the work of the devil. You are going to pray and say, Lord, frustrate every power frustrating my life. Every power that has been situated, that has designated, that has sent on an errand to come and frustrate me, Holy Ghost, frustrate them. Shall we open our mouth and pray?
Amen. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I come before you, knowing that you are a prayer asking Father, the merciful one, the mighty man in battle. I come in the name of Jesus Christ. I will frustrate every power frustrating my destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every power working against me to frustrate me financially, frustrate me spiritually, frustrate me spiritually. Business wise, in the name of Jesus Christ, frustrate them, destroy those powers, set them up in the name of Jesus Christ. I look up to you as Father and my God, my Maker, one that brings only good things in fast. Let your will be done in my life. I begin to frustrate every power of darkness, every power of enemy against my life. Frustrate them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Frustration from whom? Frustration from the community.
Frustration from
family members.
Every power of
I want you to come and do this. I want you to come and do that. You are frustrated.
Power that Lord,
in Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
There is another one that is called discouragement.
Let that power
you know,
be
we need to be tied like gold.
Let that power be frustrated.
We need to look at how David was, how Job was tried. How many people can survive what Job survived? And at a little time, we complain. At a little time, we complain. Discouragement everywhere. I'm even discouraged. I'm not interested again. I'm not interested in things of the Lord. You are not interested in doing business. You are not interested in moving forward. You suddenly lose taste over everything. My brother, it is the work of the devil. You are going to pray. Every spirit of discouragement that want to discourage me, every bow of the spirit to discourage a move of God in my life, Holy Spirit, destroy them. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray.
Amen.
He is the God of my salvation, the God of my life. Anybody can be discouraged, not me. I cannot be discouraged.
I need the encouragement of the Almighty God to overthrow every form of discouragement.
There are times where you will not even hear anything from God. It doesn't mean
in your love, in your glory,
that is because he did not want to help you. It's only a trial
in the
of faith.
Name of Set them ablaze in the mighty name of Jesus.
God is never
glorify
too late.
Yourself in
God is the owner
Magnify
of that
your
time.
Name.
You say my time is going, my time is going. Who is the owner of that time? God is the owner of that time.
Your
I refuse to be discouraged.
In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Say a louder amen.
We want to pray against sickness. Against sickness. There are some sickness we call incurable. And there are some sickness that you just have to be keeping it low. And so they give you drugs. You say, I've not taken my drug. I've not taken my drug. You keep taking drugs to suppress it. But I tell you that God can heal you if you have faith. You are going to pray any form of sickness that is projected into my message. Projected into my lineage. You know there are some sickness. This is what we used to have in our family. We are going to pray. I'm telling you that those things are arrows. God did not create you for sickness.
It is not the crown of my head.
To be under the power of any form of sickness.
Thank you, Father. I pray
in the name of God to purge you of all sickness. Whatever sickness, small sickness, big sickness, hospital sickness, incurable sickness. Look at drugs, advanced drugs, whatever it is.
I have heard about Jesus Christ. Manifest the power upon my life. Glorify your name upon my life. Take away every form of sickness that has been lingering in my life.
I will not be sick. Some people will be sick to the extent that they will die through that sickness. So the devil heal them through sickness. Why will you die like an unbeliever? Why will you die like a backslider? I refuse to be sick.
Therefore,
I will not be sick.
As long as
in the name of Jesus,
one of the properties they should get up by the power and the name of Jesus. If you name above all things, and I will mention every song professed that Jesus Christ is here today. I cancel every form of sickness of my body from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. As soon shall it be, because I believe my Lord is
here. Jesus Christ is here.
Amen.
I want to challenge you of something before I lead you to prayer. If we are not standing, if we are not fighting careful, I tell you that the enemy can get us. There was a time we were praying for somebody. And when that prayer was going on, the person we were praying for, the mother was in the village. The grandmother was in the village. So, and they have house where tenants are living there. Those tenants now call, even during the prayer, they call. Your mother has been screaming, fire, 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 pain all over her body. We want to rush her to the hospital. Our grandmother is terribly sick. In fact, she has been scattering everywhere in the middle of the night. We want to carry her, we want to take her to the hospital. We say, okay, we will come back. We continue prayer. Then we now receive another call again. He say, you know what? We don't even understand what is happening again. Because Mama is now well. Mama is very well now. But as I'm talking to you now, Baba is on his way to the hospital. We are rushing him there now. That it is Baba now that is now shouting pain all over his body. Before Baba gets to the hospital, Baba already died. What happened in that place? There is a transference of danger coming. And when the woman saw that this danger is seriously coming, a backfire is coming. It just diverted the thing to her husband. And so the husband just died straight away. Before rushing him to the hospital, he died. If we are not spiritually sound, you can be born again. No, I'm telling you, if you are not on fire, they will just fire the arrow. The arrow will enter. The fact that you are born again does not mean that you will not experience arrow. But when you are on fire, when you are seriously on fire, that is when they can fire and the thing will return back immediately. I'm telling you. And nobody will carry a cross that does not belong to you, put it on your head. I want you to pray and tell the Holy Spirit, increase my fire. I want to burn. I want to burn. I want to burn beyond manipulation. I want to burn beyond carrying another person's yoke on my head. It is a taboo. That somebody will divert something just because we are husband and wife. I want to be on fire. So many Christians are sleeping. They believe that once they are born again, School fees. We have prayed for financial liberation. We are still going to pray again. that God will provide for this person. They will pay school fees. He will have more abundantly. Shall we open our mouth and pray?
Amen.
As we are praying for them, they will
keep the name of Jesus.
The Lord will also
provide abundantly for him.
I'm just reading this one now, and this is like a challenge to me. He said, I am asking for prayer for perfect healing. It means this person have asked for perfect healing before, but the healing have not been perfected. Not that God has no answer, because there is no prayer we pray that God did not hear. But I am still praying. It means that I still need more perfection. I am still asking for prayer for perfect healing and wellness. I want to be loosened up from stiffness of my body. We want to pray now that the Holy Spirit will touch everywhere that is stiff in that body now, and there will be a free flow. There will be a proper functioning of the body parts.
We
open our mouth and pray for this person.
Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that for this writer, we pray, O Lord, for this sickness in the body,
that I pray,
let it be healed.
The
blood of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus, let the cry from the blood of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus, O Lord, we testify in the name of Jesus. Perfect healing for his body, perfect healing for our body, for our soul, for our spirit. In the name of Jesus,
we pray.
O Lord, we testify in the name of Jesus.
If you believe God has answered those requests, say aloud that amen.
Amen.
The last one we will take tonight, and I know that God will answer all other prayer points in the name of Jesus. Prayer request.
Amen.
I want people of God to join me in prayer for rapid recovery of my mother-in-law, who presently is unable to talk as a result of domestic accident. Doctors have tried, but no improvement. I believe in the power of prayer. There is one thing I want you to see here. This person is praying for his or her mother-in-law. I want you to know that this mother must be a very good person, a nice person. For you to, you are not talking of yourself, you are not talking of your children, you are not talking of your husband, you talk of your mother-in-law. She must be a good person, I'm telling you. And now, we want to pray that the Holy Spirit will perfect her healing, and there will be drastic improvement. In the name of Jesus, the hand of God will touch her. Shall we open our mouth and pray?
It is true to pray in the name of Jesus. To pray for this mother. Amen.
I want you to now tell the Lord now concerning yourself. I say, Lord, perfect everything that concerns me this very month. Shall we?
Everything that concerns me, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, has all that concerns you. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, has all that concerns you. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, has all that concerns you. Amen.
You have not said a louder amen.
Amen.
Dear Father, Lord, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you because there is no wasting of time in your presence. Thank you, Lord, because these requests are perfected. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because our faith is in place. It's at the highest frequency. Lord, according to our faith, answer us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I pray for everyone on this platform, everyone hearing the sound of my voice, they will experience breakthrough, they will experience deliverance, they will experience freedom, they will experience happiness, they will experience celebration. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will give you love. The Lord will give you happiness. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will give you life. So you will have liberty. Your children will be delivered. Your children will be saved. In the name of Jesus. Father, those that have written prayer requests, we commit them into your hands. Answer their prayer. Give them
testimony. Amen.
Thank you, Superior Father, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We want to just spend these few minutes to pray for our pastor, Pastor Matthew. We just want to call upon the name of the Lord on his behalf. We want to pray, Lord, all that concerns Pastor Matthew, Father, perfect it in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord in prayer.
Amen.
Talk to the Lord, talk to
in the name of Jesus, Matthew, I come to your able hands, Father. Everything that concerned him, we pray,
in the name of
Jesus, be perfect in the name of Jesus Christ. To yet be anything from the pit of hell.
Oh,
We also want to call upon God. We want to pray. The Bible says that the desire of the righteous shall be granted. We are standing upon the scriptures. We want to pray based on that scripture. We want to pray all the desire of Pastor Matthew, his desire for life and ministry, his desire for his family, his desire concerning whatever in his life. We want to pray, Holy Father, oh God, grant all his desire in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and call upon God. The Lord will grant. The Lord will grant all the desire of his heart, all the our desire, all that he desires. We will grant unto him in the name of Jesus. Let's pray to our desire. Let it be granted in the name of Jesus. Oh God, grant the desire of the righteous shall be granted. Oh God, grant all his desire. His desire for life, his desire for his family, his desire for his death, his desire, all his desire. His desire for life, his desire for godliness, his desire for holiness. Oh God, grant all his desire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Lastly, we want to pray. We want to call upon God. We want to talk to the Lord. We want to pray on behalf of Pastor Matthew. For Pastor Matthew, we want to pray that at the end of his life, here on earth, when all of us, you know, at one time or the other, all of us, whether we like it or not, we are going to go home. We want to pray when it is time for all of us to go. We want to pray. You are also praying for yourself. I'm praying for myself. Oh God, your kingdom, I will not miss it. Your kingdom, I will not miss it. You will not miss the kingdom of God. I will not miss the kingdom of God. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and pray. I will not miss the kingdom of God. I will not miss heaven. I will not miss heaven. I will not miss heaven. After going to church, after God, I will not more miss the kingdom of heaven. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I will not miss the kingdom of God. I will not miss the rapture. I will not miss heaven. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and call upon God. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Please, I want somebody to pray this prayer. This prayer is for somebody who wants to call upon God. You want to talk to the Lord. All satanic network. All satanic satellites, all satanic connections over your life and family, I shut you down in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. All satanic connections, all satanic network over my life and family, I shut you down. All satanic satellites, I disconnect you. 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 Open your mouth and come upon me. All satanic satellites over my life, over my family, I shut you down. 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 In the name of Jesus, thank God for this brother. Thank God for this brother. Thank God for this brother. I pray. Open your mouth and come upon me. All satanic network, all satanic satellite, all satanic connection over my life and family, I shut you down in the name of Jesus. I want you to quickly pray. I want you to talk to the Lord. In this moment, if you are living in Nigeria, you know what is happening in Nigeria. All over the world, there is action. All over, there is action. But you want to call upon God. Even in the midst of action, you will talk to the Lord. I will not lack any good thing. I will not lack any good thing. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. You will not lack good health. 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 You will not lack divine provision. You will not lack. Open your mouth and call upon God. You will not lack. I will not lack. You will not lack. You will not beg. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and call upon God. Thank God. You are the God, my provider. You are the God, my supplier. Open your mouth and call upon God. I will not lack any good thing. In the name of Jesus, I will not lack. You will not lack. You will not lack. My family will not lack. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and call upon God. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
This prayer, is for one person. It's for one person. You want to call upon God. You want to pray. Every power that is doing you, the one in your village, their powerhouse, their engine room, their powerhouse, the very source, the very origin, the very stronghold of in your family, the power that is doing you, that is affecting your life from the village, the one from the city, the one you know, the one you don't know, the invisible power, the one that is affecting your life in one way or the other. You are going to pray into your powerhouse. I set fire into your powerhouse. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and pray. Set fire into their powerhouse. Into their powerhouse. Yes, 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 yes. Set the fire there. Set the fire there. The power out of the enemy. Over your life. Over your family. Set fire there. Set fire there. Set fire there. Oh, thank God for this God. Open your mouth and pray. Set fire. Set fire. Set fire. Into their midst. Yes, yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
This prayer is for somebody. This prayer is for somebody. This prayer is for somebody. You want to call upon God. God, all those who are gathered because of me. The Bible says, associate yourself together and you shall be broken in pieces. Take counsel together, it shall not stand. We are going to call upon God. Every satanic gathering against me and my family, wherever they are, the one that are gathered in the water, in the sea, in the compound where you live, in the office where you are working, any damn God of the enemy over your life and family, whether you know them or you don't know them, those who have gathered together to harm you, to harm your family, open your mouth and call upon God. Scatter!
Thank you, Holy Spirit, because you hear us when we call. We are praying for our pastor,
yes,
Pastor Matthew Akomo, and and every other person that is represented here. Lord, we pray that you will grant our heart desire in the name of Jesus. As our petition has been raised to you, Lord, I pray that you will attend to them one by one in the name of Jesus. No pastor here, no brother here, no saint here will be a victim of circumstance. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, you will strengthen us, you will lift us up in the name of Jesus. Help us to triumph over any challenge that confront us in the name of Jesus. Help us to keep firing. Help us to keep firing in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
we will not look back, we will not backslide, we will not be frustrated in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, confirm our prayer. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In
Jesus'
name, we are praying.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We want to thank God for everyone that has attended today's prayer meeting. I pray that all the blessings we have received today will be permanent in our lives. In Jesus' name. Our pastor. The pastor is unavoidably absent because he's having another meeting. So let's keep praying for him. The Lord will continue to help him in Jesus' name. Tomorrow is the gathering of the eagles. Let's not forget. Let's meet together tomorrow by 9 p.m. 9 p.m. tomorrow. We shall share the grace now as we bring the meeting to a close. Let's share the grace together. 1, 2, 3, go. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma. The presence of the Lord will go with us in Jesus' name.
Amen.